Hi, this is Becky of Miss B Group Travel. If this is your first time on this channel, welcome. On this channel, we discuss all things travel and events. So please do consider subscribing for weekly updates. If you're a returning subscriber, I know it's been a while, but thank you for bearing with us and welcome back. Today's video is about our recent group trip to the annual event that is Royal Ascot. We attended on Ladies' Day, Thursday the 16th of June 2022, the first open Ascot since lockdown. So do stay tuned until the end of the video so that you don't miss out on some Ascot tips. Here we go. Before I share how our day went, a brief history about Ascot. Ascot Racecourse is a famous English racecourse located in Berkshire and used for thoroughbred horse racing. It is one of the leading racecourses in Britain. Ascot is closely associated with the British royal family as it is approximately 6 miles from Windsor Castle. Every year, Royal Ascot is attended by Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II and various members of the British royal family, arriving each day in horse-drawn carriages. The royal procession takes place at the start of each race day and the Queen's royal standard is raised. This year, 2022, Queen Elizabeth was not in attendance. However, other members of the royal family were in attendance, namely the Duke of Edinburgh, Prince Charles, and the Duchess of Cornwall. Also, Princess Zara Tyndall, Princess Beatrice, and Eugene arrived together in horse-drawn carriages to celebrate the event's 300th year. Royal Ascot has four different enclosures, three of which are open to the public, and one, which is the royal enclosure, is by invitation only. The great news about the three public enclosures are they are at a different price point and to suit any tempo. The first one being the Windsor enclosure. For that one, expect to pay around £49. It's positioned at the heart of the racing action. You will be the first to see the royal procession and experience the day in a more relaxed and informal environment, whilst enjoying a picnic on their extensive lawns. Whilst there is no official dress code for the Windsor enclosure, ladies are encouraged to dress in smart day wear. It is recommended that ladies wear smart attire and a hat or fascinator. And for the gentlemen, they also have recommended to wear a jacket, collared shirt and full-length trousers. The next enclosure is a village enclosure. Expect to pay about £65 plus. And this is located in the centre of the track, looking back towards the grandstand from the other side of the rail. Village enclosure guests gain a unique view of the racing as the horses thunder down the home. They have got DJs and reinvented brass bands to jazz and funk at the bandstand. Three stages of music move the village enclosure to a tempo of its own until 9 p.m. Whilst it's less formal than that of the Queen Anne enclosure, the village enclosure dress code still requires ladies and gentlemen to dress in a manner as befits a formal occasion. Then the third enclosure is a Queen Anne enclosure, and this is the enclosure that we were in. For that one, expect to pay about £99 plus. And it's located around the iconic Ascot grandstand and grants guests access to the parade ring stepping, bandstand, trackside lawns and ground floor to the grandstand. This is the Queen Anne is their most premier public enclosure at the heart of the action, and you get a spectacular view of the royal procession and the horses before and after each race from the parade ring stepping. Whilst not as strict as the royal enclosure, the dress code in the Queen Anne enclosure is formal and followed with confidence. Although I must say, this year there was no fashion police at Ascot, and I did see some outfits that would be considered a little bit risque for that event. Car parking. On this occasion, I did not book in advance. However, there was plenty of car parking available. On the day, to pay was £45, and that is for a car that is a 7-seater. So if you're sharing your trip with your friends and there's 4 of you in the vehicle, you can easily split down the middle. I will say that there also is a free shuttle bus provided by Ascot. For us who were in the Queen Anne Enclosure, we were able to park our vehicle, take the shuttle bus, which left us pretty much near the entrance. It left us by the village enclosure, and we were able to walk down up to the Queen Anne Enclosure. There are other car parking spaces around. I am not too sure about them. I've never used them. I just normally use the Ascot race car parking. And on that point, I must advise ladies, it is a lot of walking in Ascot. I do appreciate we want to look our best, and so for some, heels are comfortable throughout the day. For myself, I found it very handy to pop in some flats into my bag for later on in the day when I really was tired. I wasn't the only one. We did a shoe cam at the end of the day, so you can see us in our flats. So top tip, if you feel that you're not going to last the day in your heels, pop in some flats and you can have an enjoyable time either by alternating between your heels and your flats, or just using your flats at the end of the day. For our group, we booked a party pack direct from Ascot. For more about party packs, I will direct you to ascot.com. In this pack included our ticket into Queen Anne Enclosure. Please note, this can also be received digitally. 3 drinks vouchers for either a wine, a beer, or a soft drink. And then the Royal Ascot official program race card voucher. For your designated day, you'd get a race card. And this race card plays a critical role at any race meeting, none more so than at Royal Ascot. It has information for betting purposes. If you're a first-time bettor or new to horse betting, information like the horse stats, their jockeys, what races they have run and won and lost, the owners, where they trained, etc., etc. Also, you have to look out for special race day offers. This year, a lucky attendee won hospitality for 2 by placing a bet with Ascot before 2 p.m. So the bets were not that very expensive. Minimum was £2 to bet. Again, the race card can also be downloaded to your phone via the QPR code. It's a lovely keepsake. I'm going to keep mine. But not surprisingly, I have seen these race cards already being sold on popular e-commerce site eBay. This time, I want to special mention to Rose of Rose Collins Millinery. She made that beautiful black and white fascinator I wore on the day. Rose is a milliner who makes bespoke, luxury, handcrafted special occasion headwear for both men and women. Her hat has been featured in Vogue February UK 22 edition under the trending accessories section. She's also created hats for Housewives of Cheshire Royal Ascot at Home event in 2020. She's made hats for the West End musical Pretty Woman, and she's a milliner of choice for Alton Towers themed nights. She can be contacted on rosecollinsmillinery.com. She's also on Etsy as Rose Collins Millinery, Instagram and Facebook. Do check out and follow her pages. She has some amazing designs, and of course, do support. A highlight of Royal Ascot in the Queen Anne Enclosure is singing around the bandstand. At the end of each racing day of the week, the racegoers all come together for a sing-along. It is truly a fantastic event, and we absolutely loved it. There were songs like When the Saints Go Marching In, Sweet Caroline, New York, New York. And there's an app that you can download all the songs that the band will be singing, and you can sing along to it. I have a few embarrassing videos of me singing Delilah totally off key, but it was a fantastic end to the day, and we look forward to next year to bigger, brighter and a more fascinating time at Ascot. Thank you so much for your time, and enjoy the rest of the video.